TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I am Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 16th of January. Foreign ministers of India, Iran hold talks in New Delhi. Pakistan's ruling PTI ally PMLQ reconcile after successful talks. Human Rights Watch report suggests civilian toll in Afghanistan devastating. And now for all the details. Indian Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar on Thursday met his Iranian counterpart Mohammad Javad Zarif in capital New Delhi and exchanged views on regional and global issues of mutual interest.
Indian Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar on Thursday met his Iranian counterpart Mohammad Javad Zarif in New Delhi and exchanged views on regional and global issues of mutual interest, including the recent developments in the West Asia region. The two leaders met over breakfast and recalled positive outcomes of the 19 Joint Commission meeting, especially for strengthening bilateral trade and promoting connectivity initiative through Chabahar Port, the Indian Foreign Ministry said. Zarif had earlier met Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday after attending the Raisina Dialogue and annual geopolitical conference in New Delhi. His participation assumed significance as the global attention is focused on US-Iran tensions post the killing of Iran's most powerful military commander Qasem Soleimani by a US drone strike earlier this month.
India's Chief of Defence Staff, General Bipin Rawat, said on Thursday that terrorism will remain as long as there are states that sponsor it and the only way to end it is like America after 9/11. He made the statement at the Raisina Dialogue, India's flagship conference on geopolitics and geoeconomics.
India's Chief of Defence Staff, General Bipin Rawat, said on Thursday that terrorism will remain as long as there are states that sponsor it, and the only way to end it is like America after 9/11 terrorist attacks. Speaking on a panel on countering terrorism at the ongoing Raisina Dialogue, General Bipin Rawat said, terrorism was here to stay so long as there were going to be states that were going to sponsor terrorism, and they are going to use terrorists as proxies. He also called for the international isolation of Pakistan.
We have to bring an end to terrorism, and that can only happen the way the Americans started after 9/11, they said, let's go on a spree on global war on terror and let the nations join together and fight terrorism together. Well, to do that, what do you have to do? You have to isolate the terrorists. Anybody who's sponsoring terrorism has to be taken to task.
Meanwhile, underlining that terror groups are active in Pakistan, Gareth Bale, UK Foreign and Commonwealth Officer Director for South Asia, said, Islamabad should do more to take non-reversible action against terrorism if it wants to prevent itself from being blacklisted by the Financial Action Task Force or FATF. FATF warned that Islamabad would be put on the blacklist if it did not comply with the remaining 22 out of 27 points related to anti-money laundering and counter-terrorist financing.
In news from Pakistan, the ruling Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf and its ally Pakistan Muslim League Qaid or PMLQ reconciled on Wednesday following successful talks. A PTI negotiation team met PMLQ leaders after the party warned explosive consequences over differences on power sharing and development funds.
Prime Minister Imran Khan's ruling Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf or PTI and its coalition partner the Pakistan Muslim League Qaid or PMLQ reconciled on Wednesday following successful talks. This came after PTI government's negotiation team including Defence Minister Parvez Khattak and senior PTI leader Jahangir Tareen met a delegation of its allies' leaders. hours after the PMLQ warned it of explosive consequences over its demands to let it run its ministries with absolute authority and immediately release development funds. Reports have suggested the PTI has started efforts to appease its annoyed allies, as the departure of coalition partners can cause a serious blow to it, since it holds only a slender majority in the National Assembly. Earlier this week, Mutahida Qaumi Movement leader Khalid Maqbool Siddiqui announced that he was resigning from his post as Federal Minister for Information Technology over unfulfilled promises in Sindh province. Siddiqui, however, clarified that his party would not be ending its cooperation with the PTI-led government.
Amid rising inflation, the government of Pakistan increased fuel prices for January, raising the petrol price to ₹116.60 per litre. Residents in Karachi city, already irked by the rising inflation, expressed their anguish over the move. They requested Prime Minister Imran Khan's government to intervene, as the hike has paralysed their daily budget.
Pakistan government revised the prices of petroleum products and liquefied petroleum gas for January after approving the recommendations made by the Oil and Gas Regulatory Authority. The petrol price has been raised to ₹116.60 per litre, with an increase of ₹2.61. Residents in Karachi city, already irked by the rising inflation, complained that with the hike in petrol price, everything they use in day-to-day life has simultaneously been affected. They said the step has paralyzed already burdened poor people working hard to earn square meal a day, and the budget of middle class people has already shaken.
Jo karobari tabka hai uske hisab se to phir bhi sahi hai, magar jo gareeb tabka hai uske liye bilkul sahi nahi hai, najayiz hai. Tabdili sarkar ko iske bare mein sochna chahiye. Imran Khan sahab se main request karta hu ki iske bare mein sochein. जो जिससे मीशत चलता पहिया चलता है उसके बारे में सोचें. अगर बहुत फेयरली कह रहा हूँ,
यहाँ तो टैक्स बढ़ाए जा रहे हैं, हुकूमत को अपना फ़ायदा नज़र आ रहा है और ये प्रोजेक्ट जो इन लोग के कंप्लीट नहीं हो रहे, बस इस वजह से बस समझे कि एक तरीके से आवाम को खाया जा रहा है यहाँ बैठ के, और कुछ नहीं, आवाम को परेशान करने का एक नया तरीका ये.
The economic situation in Pakistan has been worrying for the past few months, with ever-increasing debt eating up some 30% of the budget every year. While Prime Minister Imran Khan's government is failing to raise revenue, the country continues to take out loans to be able to cover repayments of past borrowing, ultimately making the citizens suffer.
Moving on, the Human Rights Watch in its World Report 2020 has said that attacks by all parties to Afghanistan's armed conflict last year took a devastating toll on civilians. In its report, it said that the deaths from Afghan government and US operations were more than those caused by the Taliban.
Attacks by all parties to Afghanistan's armed conflict last year took a devastating toll on civilians, the Human Rights Watch has said in its World Report 2020. The non-governmental organization in its latest report said that for the first time, the deaths caused by the Afghan government and United States operations exceeded those caused by the Taliban, largely due to increased US airstrikes. The report further suggested the Taliban carried out indiscriminate attacks, particularly before the September presidential elections, and claimed that the group also carried out summary executions, torture and ill treatment, including forced labor of prisoners. The Taliban fighting the US-backed government in Afghanistan controls more of the country than at any time since being removed from power. The group has stepped up a campaign of suicide attacks in recent years as Washington tries to pull its forces out.
In news from Nepal, a blast on Wednesday night damaged two cars and windows of various houses in Nursery Chowk locality in Nepal's capital Kathmandu. Netra Bikram Chand-led Banned Communist Party of Nepal has taken responsibility for the blast.
Cleaning was in progress in Nursery Chowk in Nepal's capital Kathmandu on Thursday after an explosion took place in the locality on Wednesday night. Two cars and window panes of various houses around Nursery Chowk were shattered by the blast that was claimed by the banned Communist Party of Nepal, led by Netraj Bikram Chand. However, no casualties were reported in the incident. The target of Wednesday's attack was the house of one of the accused involved in the high-profile Lalita Nivas scam, in which a large area of government-owned land was unscrupulously brought into private ownership and sold to various individuals. Netra Bikram Chand-led banned Communist Party of Nepal has been accused of vandalizing government properties and for blasts throughout the nation over the Lalita Nivas scam. A series of blasts by the party last year claimed at least 4 lives in capital Kathmandu alone.
Members of Nepal's ethnic Tharu community marked their new year on Wednesday with dance and music as they visited a fair to celebrate the special occasion in Kathmandu. Dressed in colourful traditional attires, people were seen enjoying and dancing.
People belonging to Tharu community in Nepal on Wednesday celebrated Maghi festival with much fanfare in capital Kathmandu, which marks the beginning of their new year. Dressed in colourful traditional attires, people congregated at a fair to celebrate the special occasion. Visitors at the fair relished different food items and spent time with their family and friends. On this day, members of the community wake up early in the day, take a dip in rivers and pray for the well-being of their families and relatives.
आज हामी थारुहरुको माघे चाड हाम्रो थारुहरुको लागि एकदमै महत्त्वपूर्ण चाड हो हाम्रो थारु कल्चरको लागि यो एउटा न्यू इयर जस्तै नै हो हामी सबै थारुहरु चाहिँ यो दिनलाई एकदमै स्पेशल बनाउँछौं किनभने यो वर्षको एक दिन मात्रै आउँछ अनि एक दिन नै हाम्रो लागि एकदमै मेन नै हुन्छ के त्यो हाम्रो न्यू इयर नै हो हाम्रो कल्चरको लागि
During the festival, Tharus clean and decorate their homes to welcome their new year while also performing Sakya Nach, a special dance organized during the festival. The Maghi festival that marks the beginning of the Hindu month of Magh symbolizes the end of cold nights and the beginning of warmer days. The Tharu people celebrate it as New Year, during which they also elect new leaders to head their community.
People across southern India celebrated the harvest festival of Pongal with great zeal and fervor on Wednesday. During the 4-day long festival, Hindu devotees worship the sun god and cook an offering of a sweet dish made of rice and jaggery.
People across southern India soaked in the festivities of the harvest festival of Pongal on Wednesday. During the 4-day long festival, people make murals, worship the sun god, and cook an offering of a sweet dish made of rice and jaggery in earthen pots. Pongal is a popular festival, especially in southern Tamil Nadu province, which marks the commencement of the sun's 6-month-long journey towards the north. Originally celebrated exclusively by the Tamil farming community, Pongal has now also become an important festival among non-farming Hindu communities in towns and urban areas. Jaggery is the most sought-after item in the markets during this time as it is an essential ingredient for making the sweet dish.
Uranda vellam, achchi vellam, karumbu sakkara, ella irukku. Pongalukku adhigama uranda vellam poduvaanga. Uranda vellam dhaan podumakkal vaangi pongal vechi saapiduvaanga.
Devotees across parts of southern India queued up in temples on Wednesday with much adoration and held prayers to express gratitude to the gods for their blessings in acquiring a prosperous harvest. Pongal coincides with harvest festivals, Lohri in northern Punjab, Bihu in northeastern Assam and Makar Sankranti celebrated in the rest of India.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.